No arms? You ever see that Mighty Python show? Mighty Python leg cutting all of her legs off. He still want to fight you with no arms and no legs. That's not how I am. I'll be rolling my head over. I'll be the head detective, just rolling. Those who are old enough to remember the head detective, y'all know what I'm talking about. In Living Color. You laugh because you remember. That's real. That's how I am. So please, 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 I implore you to educate your family about the things that are happening and the importance of why we have to protect mother. Because the hand that rocked the cradle rules the world. Think about Hitler's mama. Now Hitler was a vegetarian. Does that mean all vegetarians are wicked as hell? No, seriously. Hitler was a vegetarian. Does it mean that all vegetarians are wicked as hell? Now, as soon as you find out he's a vegetarian, everybody says, no, I ain't gonna be no vegetarian. Hitler was one. Oh, hell no. I might turn out to be like him. What you saying, brother?
Dr. Savy said Hitler had it right. I don't know.
Hitler had what right?
About the Jews.
What he had right. The only thing that what happened with Hitler is that he was against the powerful Jews of that time that was starting to control society. And remember, his family, part of his family, was Jewish. People, that name was not Hitler, that was his astrologer's name. His real name was Spickelberg or Spicklestein, some of them names. That was his original name. He took his astrologer's last name and used it. That was his astrologer. So he was into all that stuff, astrology, numerology. Now, just because I'm a numerologist or astrologer, that make every astrologer wicked just because Hitler practiced astrology? We gotta just stay focused. That's why mother is so important. Because we don't know what trauma that his mother went through to produce somebody like him. We don't know the trauma of what happened to Mobutu's mother to produce a person like him to go against Patrice Lumumba. We don't know why W.E.B. Du Bois went against Marcus Garvey.
And Booker T.
Cone. Booker T. Washington. That's what. Booker T. Washington. But yet, Booker T. fashioned people like Malcolm. Through his studies, I'm studying him. People like W.E.B. Du Bois, Malcolm was studying these people to make him who he became. So the goodness of what they learned and what they were able to impart surpassed some of the bad stuff they did, because at the end of W.E.B. Du Bois' life, he still ended up going to Africa and dealing with Africa in his own and dying and living in Ghana. So we got to really study and research. Now, May 19th, there's a bus trip to Malcolm X's grave.
Thursday,
this Thursday coming up. It's absolutely free, but you can give a donation. They want you to give a nice handsome donation. I might go, since I'll be in town, I'm not leaving until next week. I might just go for that, though. The buses leave at 9 a.m. The buses, we gotta be there by 9 a.m. The buses leave at 10 a.m. if you wanna go to Malcolm X's site. And that's where, on Adam Clayton, Bowell Powell, and 125th Street. So if you wanna go this Thursday, we're gonna have a line of buses over there at Adam Clay Powell and 125th Street Thursday, 9 in the morning, be there, because we're gonna leave together at 10 o'clock with Professor James Smalls, Dr. Jeffries, and various other people. We're gonna do a whole ceremony out there. And if you've never been to a grave, if you've never been to a ceremony around a memorial or grave site, these brothers and sisters be putting it in, especially with the whole Semitic knowledge and all that kind of stuff. They put it in, and it's a very good event to go to. Also, want to let you know what we got coming up. First and foremost, next week, Saturday and Sunday, we got an event at the, my friends got an event at the King's Theater. Sister used to work there, she knows that. They're doing a play called Married But Single. With Carl Payne from The Martin Show. We got Lisa Ray McCoy, she gonna be there. Darren Henson gonna be there, Cassette Michelle. Matter of fact, Cassette Michelle came here to the store one time. And also, LaMaya Good is gonna be also there. That's gonna be at the King's Theater on May the 21st, May the 22nd. That's gonna be a great event. Also on, let me see, there it goes. These are a few events that I'm a part of. On June the 25th at Coney Island Boardwalk, we are doing an event. I'm supposed to be one of the MCs for this with Ziggy Marley, Steel Post, Maxi Priest, Ed Robinson, and there's a few more that's gonna be added, but it's Marley and Friends. So Ziggy Marley is coming to do have a good time with Bob Marley. Give a round of applause to Bob Marley, please. Bob Marley, man. Bob Marley said to his wife, he said,
"They might go tired to see me face. Can't take me out of the race."
Bob Marley's children and grandchildren are doing stuff in this business. They never gonna stop seeing Bob Marley. I've seen his great-grandchildren look like him.
They never gonna stop seeing this man, and he prophesied it a long time ago.
That's what it takes to keep a legacy alive, and we forgot that we have generational things that we have to keep and uphold. All this out here is generationally built. You can look at Macy's, and look at Citibank, and look at Chase Manhattan Bank, and J.P. Morgan, and all this. This is legacies they're leaving. What are we doing? We gotta leave legacies and institutions and manufacturing companies and all that just like them. We can do it. Also, on August the 20th and the 21st, myself and Irritated Genie and a few other people are gonna be doing a Straight Black Pride Family Day in Washington, D.C. and convention for 2 days. Meaning we're straight, we black, and we proud. That's all it's telling. We straight. Let me hear it. We straight, we black, and we proud. We're trying to foster a better relationship with men and women together. I don't care what the Europeans are pushing on us with the Greco-European, the Alexander type of mentality. I don't care about that. But I do care about what our children are getting in the school systems now. So mothers, y'all gotta be very cognizant of what your children are learning in the school system. They put it in the name of they put it under the name or under the disguise of multiculturalism. Homosexuality and pedophilia and all that stuff is coming under multiculturalism. That's why they got a group out there called NAMBLA, which is the National Association of Men, Boy, Love, trying to come on in so they can lower the statute of limitations for men or children and adults having sex. So we gotta be mindful of what's about. Since the Catholic Church been doing it all their life, we gotta be very careful what's going on now. We gotta be very mindful. See, when a child gets touched, I don't care what age they are, it affects them. And those women who've been raped or molested in any way, those that are gonna be watching this on DVD or watching this on YouTube, you gotta break the cycle. The cycle has to be broken. And if the brother did it in the hip-hop world, he has to break the cycle because he has to let people know that he was molested or something happened to him. Because only somebody who was traumatized through that as a child can probably continue to do the same thing over and over again if he's not stopped or he's not getting any help. So we all must keep our children in mind, be very careful, mindful of our babies. I love my babies, so I got 9 children, so I can't be playing around with that. Sister, look at me, you got 9 children. What you talking about? Where you get 9 children from? I didn't watch television, sister. Just no TV. Just no television at all. I got a lot of TV, that's why I don't have no children now. I ain't making no more babies. I'm just playing, babe. I'm just playing this year. I know she ain't listening to me. But we got a brother coming up in a few minutes. You ready? You ready, Josh? You all right? I got a brother that's gonna give you some drumming real quick just to set it off, just to warm the hearts up with some drumming. And this brother's an excellent speaker himself, but also an excellent drummer. And, you know, my brother, he's doing his thing, and he's also an author of the book. Tell him the name of the book, brother. Black Hole. Is it here? Any books are here? Where are your books at? Any books here? It's on one of these shelves over here, but I always promote what he got going on because this brother does, he hosts the open mics that we have here. Every time we do it, he hosts various other open mics all over the place. He's been winning concerts with you take that off. Put it right to the side there, yeah. But this brother is a great brother. Give you a well-deserved round of applause to my brother, Joshua Sara. Come on, put your name, put your hands together for Joshua Sara.
Yeah, I will. That's King Simon, as y'all know. So y'all, yeah, give him a round of applause. He's so fucking freaking working. I'm gonna play this drum for y'all. And I want y'all to think about, since we're here to celebrate the women and the mothers, think about that the first sound that any being hears is the heartbeat of their mother, the pulsing of the blood going through them. And really advanced societies always protect the mothers, the pregnant women in particular, because they're carrying the children. And whatever happens to the mother is happening to the child before they even know what it's working out, getting that lens of the mother. So, you know, certain words we won't say around pregnant women, certain images we won't show around pregnant women, certain sounds, certain smells. If you just think about when you're watching a movie, you know, when it's the scary person's about to come around the corner, they give you music, you already know what's coming. So it's kind of like that, like the music lets you know what's happening in the world. So when the child is hearing a heartbeat, if it's accelerated and she's in a fear state, then the baby in there is thinking, this is a fearful thing we're coming into. If it's relaxed and peaceful and calm, then the baby's like, oh, okay, I picked the right place to come into. So be real mindful, not just of your own women who are pregnant, but I mean, if you're out in the streets, protect them too, you know, it's a generation. These children are going to be voting for people one day that's going to take care of y'all. So join me in heartbeat. Y'all don't have to look at me, just here, you know.
Thank you. can regulate the speed of your heart by your breathing, which is why our ancestors used to sing while they worked. Because if you're singing together, then you're breathing together, which also puts your hearts together. So y'all can't forget those kind of technologies of easy ways to bring us back together.
On just change versus transition. just a conversation that I would like to see more discussed in our communities, okay? Like, everybody's calling for change, we're asking for change, we're fighting for change, but we're not having the discussion on transition. How do you begin to transition once the change has happened? Because change is situational, okay? We've been changing, it's the only thing that remains constant, right? So it's not change that we're looking for. We're looking for stability. We're looking for security. We're looking to be in a space where, okay, this is us. This is, yes, this is my community. This is my identity. This is who I'm proud to be, you know? So just a brief discussion on that. So still, 2 weeks ago, I said this piece at the New York Urban League of Young Professionals. Those young people over there held an event raising money for students in the Whitney M. Young Scholarship Program. The New York Urban League Young Professionals are young Black Americans, Latino Americans between the ages of 21 to 40, and that group raised $9,000. For the youth and for the Whitney M. Young, so it was amazing. So this is the piece that I shared there. It's called Still. Still waiting for people to say excuse me instead of excusing themselves. I never did quite understand entitlement and shared spaces. Maybe it's me looking for space in entitled places. Locked in, locked out, nowhere to go, eyes burning. Could it be my soul turning, yearning? This lurk behavior has gotten me nowhere but pretending. Pretending to have control. I have no control. Who's in control? The more you know, the more you realize you don't know. Nonsense. The more you know, the more you have to do to keep things in control. Challenges are for winners. I apologize in advance for becoming a sinner. The first time I met love is when I saw my mother. If you're not willing to put your life on the line, it's not the truth. Everyone knows the truth of who they are, who they were, going nowhere fast. Slow down. Stop feeling yourself. Start freeing yourself. Stop letting pain last longer than its intent. It always hurts in the beginning. Untapped territory, free will, open path, picture God's laugh. I can still hear the echo. I laugh, I'm laughing, I be laughing, I stay laughing. Two tears, through tears, at some point you'll dance. At some point you'll smile. God's delay is not thou's denial. Everything in time. In with the new, out with the old. Why can't I talk to myself? Crazy, huh? I still believe in myself. Persevering, crazy. Sometimes you need to hear yourself. Hear the water of the breeze that has brought balance to the heat. Hear the melodies of sweet cake filling your teeth. Hear the shedding of skin as you redefine yourself. Hug someone, share your love again. Funny, there's that love thing again, and I'm still the common denominator. Still. So I hope you guys enjoy that piece, Still. Thank you. You know, it's in that stillness that we are reminded of the truth that never left. That stillness, you know, understanding that about ourselves and what still remains. Like, we are still here. You know, thousands and thousands and thousands of years later, like, we're still here. We're still the common denominator. We're still that. And so, needless to say, you know, as a mother and as a young Black woman, I have to constantly remind myself, remind my family, remind my sisters that, hey, listen, we're still here, not by default, but by divine reason, right? And we're not asking for change anymore. Like, we're over that, right? We're over, like, hey, you know, we want change. We want change. We're not with that no more. Okay? We're in a space where we're teaching our children, we're teaching our family, we're teaching ourselves how to stand in this transition. Because as I said before, the biggest difference between change and transition is that change is situational and transition is psychological. what you call it. Right, there's that word. There's that word, that one word. Psychological. That's where we at. That's why we're not fighting for change anymore. Okay, the physical aspect of it has happened, but the change, the psychological paralysis that continues to keep us in an economic paralysis is what we need to discuss, is what the approach that we have to come to. And as mothers, you know, it starts with us, because we are birthed in life. We are constantly birthed in life, and if we don't get that, who else is going to get it? Who else is going to get it? Transition, psychological, we're going through, that's what we're stuck into. The brothers in the hood, the sisters in the hood, they're getting so mad, they're still at the corner, they're still doing it, they're stuck in a psychological paralysis. It's not just enough to give them the knowledge of their past, to give them the knowledge of, you know, Egyptology, of the Kemetics, and even if our Christian followers going back to, you know, Ethiopia being, you know, the home of some of the oldest monasteries. Like, it's so much, but it's information overload to a lot of them. It's information overload. Because guess what? We're here now. So the six main points of change versus transition. It isn't the changes that do you in, it's the transitions. Change is situational. Transition is psychological, and oftentimes it's a three-phase process. Getting people through transition is essential if the change is actually going to work as planned. See, that's the thing, we've been having plans. We've been having plans on how we're going to change, how we're going to break free. We got underground this hour right now reminding us of what our people did just for their freedom. But we haven't quite gotten the transitional part of it. What do we do now? Now that we have this quote-unquote freedom to a certain extent, what's the work that now needs to be done? Now that we're physically free, that work is our mental, our psychological healing. When change happens without people going through a transition, what is that going to be called? Rearrangement. So you just did it. You just change, right? You just rearrange the situation of the mind, Wash. That wasn't me. Can sign the word on here.
Just leave it right there.
All right.
That's a piece of the chair. All right.
Change and transition should not and cannot be used interchangeably. We should give each one its due respect, that its due, I guess, celebration, so to speak. Like, okay, we did get through this step. And as we got through this step, the next one is we're transitioning. The first phase of transition is an ending. It's a time where you need to help people deal with their losses. As a change agent to the African American community, we must ask ourselves what era is ending and what have and will we lose as a result. Everybody's scared to lose something, but we have to lose something. That's the first phase of transition, is as an ending. The second phase of transition is called a neutral zone. It's going through the in-between time when the old is gone, but the new isn't quite fully operational. Like, you're quite not getting it yet. You know something feels different, but when you look around you, everything seems to be the same. But it's happening here first, and we're not feeding that, we're not protecting that, we're not nurturing that, we're not cleansing that, we're not detoxing that, we're going from one philosophy to the next. When that don't fit us no more, we go into the next philosophy. And when that don't fit us no more, we go into the next philosophy, because we need identity. Culture is all we have. So who are we? Right? Like, that's the second phase of transition, the neutral zone. And it's both a danger.